Magandang araw mga kabusing at welcome back sa ating Muntin Channel. Binigyang aral ng isang Pinoy ang European Union Bantamweight Champion. Matapos itong magyabang sa harap ng Pinoy, nagpakita ng pag-aangas sa laban at tinilaan pa ng harap-harapan ang former 4 Division World Champion. Matapos maging kampiyon si Dunayre sa Super Featherweight Division, ay dito naman ito nakatikim ng pinakamasakit na talo sa buong boxing career. Kaya sa muling pagbangon ni Dunayre sa pagkadapa, ay napalaban agad ito sa isang regional and minor title. Pero bumaba ito ng division sa kanyang kinagis ng timbang sa Super Bantamweight Division, na ang laban ay ginanap sa bansang Pinas, at nakuha naman ni Dunayre ang impresibong panalo via technical knockout sa loob ng round 2. At sa pangalawang laban ni Dunayre sa division, ay dito niya nakalaban ang naging kampiyon sa Ibo European Union Bantamweight title, na isang kampiyon rin sa kanilang bansa sa France Bantamweight title, na si Anthony Sitol. May tangkad na 5'7 at isang orthodox, taong 2015 na makaharap nito ang ating kababayan na si Dunayre para sa isang tune-up fight, 10 rounds of boxing, na pinaglalabanan ang Super Bantamweight Division. Sa labang ito ay may edad pa lang itong si Sitol na 28 years old at may ring record na 20 wins, 3 losses and 8 knockout. Samantala naman si Dunayre sa panahong ito ay mataas na ang napatunayan nito sa larangan ng boxing at naging kampiyon na sa 4 na division. Dala-dala nito ang kanyang disinting ring record na 34 wins, 3 losses and 22 knockout, na ang laban ng dalawang boksingero ay naging common event sa bakbakan na ginanap sa Macau, China. Halika't ating balikan ang laban ni Dunayre kung paano ito minaliit dinilaan ng kalaban sa harap-harapan.
Really stay under control. The colors of the French flag on the trunks of Anthony Sotul. Nonito decked out in the black trunks with the gold trim. Nonito really went back to work after his loss to Walters. Training really hard. He wants to get his jab going for him. He doesn't want to depend on just his power like he tried to in the Rigondeaux fight and couldn't catch up with Rigondeaux. Well, he hopes he'll be able to catch up with Sotul. And got the attention of Sotul. Sotul set up right in front of him, not a lot of sideways movement, which suits Donaire just fine. Donaire taking his time here in the early going. In his last fight, Donaire stopped to William Prieto, kind of a journeyman fighter in the second round, and then fight in Manila at 122 pounds. A little bit heavy, 123 is Donaire for this fight. Nito loaded up that shot. He wants to work on his jab. His dad's been working with him and trying to get him back to the disciplined sort of fighter that he was. And he said to me, even though he knocked out his last opponent, Prado, he wanted to work more with him. And when he saw the blood and when he hurt him, he went after him. I said, when I talked to him after him, that's what fighters do. He says, I don't care, but I gotta stay under control. Well, he looks pretty much under control right here. Got the jab working for him. Sotul hasn't been able to do too much so far. Gets the jab through. Nito a little bit quicker with the hands. Not getting a lot of head movement. Not too much to the body by either guy.
Down!
Oh, yeah, delayed the reaction to a chop.
Three!
It's four, up to four.
Five!
Can he get up?
Six
and seven! And he finally
eight.
Comes
Come
up
on.
At eight. I don't know what happened there, but there was
okay.
A delayed reaction.
Ready, box.
One of the shots that Danilo Donaire landed. So let's see if Donaire can stay under control here with 35 seconds to go in this round. He's right on top of him. He clipped him with a pretty solid right hand. Like he's hurting pretty much with 20 seconds to go in this round. Delayed reaction, something caught him to the far, my far left, and it looked like a right hand. He's body shot in the area of the liver, taking a throw as well on Sotul. Hard shot. Just about
on.
Out of time in this round.
Okay. Box.
what he wants to be able to do with Sandhu, and it's working very, very well as he scored two knockdowns in the first round. One with a right hand upstairs with a delayed reaction by Sandhu, and then a real vicious body shot in the area of the liver that took him down right at the end of the closing seconds of round number one. Sandhu, I don't know if he's totally recovered yet, but Donito's moving well. He wants to get back to his jab. He doesn't want to, you know, go wild. This is what he told me that he wanted to do, is stay under control. He trained very, very hard for this fight because he knows another world title is on the line, a couple of uppercuts. That sort of punch with the left hand, you know, is a body shot just waiting to happen. There it is there in the right hand. Comes upstairs a couple of times. We would want to say a body shot waiting to happen. You know what he's thinking is to get those hands up to protect the head and get back down to the body. Whacks him on the left ear, does Donito Donaire. Donaire, of course, with his back to you in the black trunks and the red trunks down to the right of your screen, is Anthony Setoul, the guy from France, having problems in the first round, down twice. Setoul will get his jab out there, but Donito able to slip it.
Oh, down!
For the third time in the fight.
Three!
It's up to three.
Four!
Seven, and he's back up at eight. So down one, that time by a right hand.
Oh.
The third time he's been down, and the corner throws in the towel, saying we don't want him to.
Impresibong pagbabalik ni Donaire sa loob ng ring, nakuha pa rin nito ang panalo sa loob ng round 2 by a technical knockout. Matapos dila-dilaan ng kalaban ay pinabagsak naman niya ito ng isang beses sa round 1, at sa round 2 naman ay dalawang beses. Hanggang sumurinder na ang kampo nito at pinalipad na ang sagisag sa pagkatalo ng puting tuwalya. So yan lang muna ang ating video sa ngayon, mga kabusing. Maraming salamat po.